हेलो एवरीवन, वेलकम टू माय चैनल शाह सर क्लासेस एंड एवरशाइन कोचिंग सेंटर। आई एम शाह फैसल सर हियर। माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स, टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस क्लास 10th कर्नाटका स्टेट बोर्ड सब्जेक्ट साइंस ऑफ द एकेडमिक ईयर 2019 क्वेश्चन पेपर। एंड रिमेंबर, फ्रॉम 1819 ऑनवर्ड्स our Karnataka state board has changed the syllabus to new syllabus. Okay, the students currently who is going to write the exam for 2021-2022 of SSLC, I want you have to refer your previous year question papers since 2019 onwards. So you can refer 2019 annual paper and supplementary paper and 2020 annual and supplementary paper. So by keeping an reference, you people can refer four papers. Okay, 2021 it was MCQ exam, so you no need to refer that paper, but at least we have to solve these four papers so that you will get an idea how will be the questions could be asked in the board exam. So today we are going to do the analysis of 2019 question paper. It is one of the most important paper. I want you all have to solve this paper. Okay, so here we will be discussing the questions related to this paper, and also I will guide you which are the questions you want to study and which are the questions you don't want to study. It means already you all knows it, 20% syllabus are reduced, right? 20% syllabus has got reduced. Some topic of metal, some topic of carbon and its compounds, human eye and colorful world, the chapter is deleted, correct? So etc. Sustainable management of natural resources, the full chapter is deleted. Are you getting my point? Good. So I'll let you know which are the topics you want to eliminate. Now as you can see, the first question, the change that occurs in the eye to see the distant objects clearly is. Actually, this question belongs to, if you see the condition like eye, okay, or ciliary muscles or something related to eye, it means this topic is related to human eye and the colorful world. So unfortunately, this question is deleted. So we are not going to focus on this question, okay. We just try to focus only on those specific questions which is required to face this year paper. Next question, and I want, my dear students, you can copy down the answers also. It will be helpful for you while you are going to answer these questions later on. Okay, question number 2. Now, as you can see here, next question number 2, the functional groups present in propanol and propanol respectively are. Okay, propanol and propanol. In this functional group, so this topic is related to carbon and its compounds. So they are asking you which is the functional group which is present in propanol, as you can see OL, okay, and next is propanol, AL, AL group, OL group. So which is the functional group is present in propanol and propanol? The options are OH, CHO, OH, COOH, CHO, COOH, CHO, CO. Remember here, if the word is ending with OL, okay, so the functional group is OH. So what is the functional group? OH. If it is ending with AL, then the functional group is CHO. Remember. So already you have the table in your textbook. You can just. So, I just want you have to study functional group, the table, okay. You have the table in your chapter, in the chapter carbon and its compounds related to functional group. Are you getting my point? So, based upon this, one question has been asked in this year, okay. In propanol, what is the functional group of propanol? OH group. What is the functional group of propanol? CHO group. CHO group. We called as? CHO group. So option A is the correct answer. Next question, number 3. The correct path of the movement of nerve impulses in the following diagram is. nerve impulse from where it starts and where it ends. They are asking you the correct order. As you can see here, okay, from where the nerve impulses are going to originate and from which order to which order they move. Okay, actually, as you can see here, the option here is, first is P. It is P. So, this P we call it as dendrites, correct? They are asking you the correct path, in which order it moves. Okay, the impulses moves in which order, from P, and next is R, and next is S, and then is Q. They will follow the order. Options are, they are asking you, either they will follow the order, first Q, then S, then R, then P. Option A. Or they will follow the order, first P, then directly they comes to Q, from then they will come to R, and then the impulses will go to S. Is this is the correct order? Option C. First they will go to S, the impulses first they reach S, and then they will reach R, that is cell body. From axon it goes to cell body, after cell body it goes to nerve endings, and then it goes to the dendrites. Is it the correct order? Option D. First it goes to dendrites, from dendrites it comes to cell body, from cell body it reaches to axon, from axon it reaches to nerve ending. So which is the correct order, correct path? That is option D. Very good. Are you getting my point? As you can see here, can you see this nerve ending? Again this nerve ending, they will interconnect with these dendrites. Again from these dendrites, it comes to cell body. Again from the cell body, it reaches to axon. Again from axon, again it comes to nerve ending. Can you see this? Again this nerve ending, again they will connect to dendrites. They will connect to dendrites. Again from dendrites comes to cell body. From cell body to axon. Again from axon to nerve ending. Understood? So here as you can see, this nerve ending is connected with what? Dendrites. Got it? So these nerve endings, they will connect to whom? The next dendrite, the next neuron. Understood? This is one neuron. This one neuron, it will connect with another neuron. So that the impulses will transfer from one neuron to another neuron. And hence, the impulses will follow the order P to R, R to S, S to Q. Again from Q to P. Again P to R, R to S, S to Q. Again from Q to P. So this order will goes on continued. Understood? So this is the correct order. So they can ask you this kind of diagrammatical questions also. They'll give diagram. From the diagram they can ask you some basic questions to understand how much clarity you have with the subject. Understood? Here no mugging you up, the answers are required. Got it? For this type of questions, you are not supposed to mug up any answers. Any doubts? Next question. The resistance of a conductor is 27 ohm. Resistance is denoted by R. That is 27 ohm. Resistance of a conductor is 27 ohm. It is cut into 3 equal parts. Now, as you can see, this is my resistor. Okay, actually resistor will come like this. Understood? But I am just showing with the box. Got it? I am just representing in the form of box. Now I am going to cut this into 3 equal parts. After cutting this into 3 equal parts, then I am connecting this into parallel. I am connecting this one resistor. After cutting into 3 equal parts, then I am connecting this into parallel. As you can see, so these are the resistors when they are connected in parallel. It looks like this. Got it? It looks like this. Now the resistors are connected in parallel now. So what is the resistance first? 27 ohm. So this resistance was 27 ohm. First the resistance was 27 ohm. Now this 27 ohm resistance, I am dividing into 3 parts. I am cutting this into 3 parts and I am connecting them into parallel. Okay. then its total resistance is. So what is its total resistance? Are you getting my point? Please see the question. The resistance of a conductor is 27 ohm. This 27 ohm conductor resistance I am cutting into 3 equal parts and then I am connecting them into parallel. Then what is its total resistance? Now my dear students, I hope you know that when the resistance are connected in series, that is 1 by Rp is equals to 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by R3. This is the formula when the resistance are connected in parallel. If the resistance are connected in series, then the effective resistance or total resistance is R1 plus R2 plus R3. We have only two formulas. If the resistors are connected in parallel, we have the formula what? Important formula. Please make a note. 1 by Rp is equals to 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by R3. Since we have three resistors we are connected in parallel. Are you getting my point? Yeah. But now they are asking you, what is the effective resistance? What is the total resistance? Okay. Now, let me solve this problem here. As you know that, first the resistor which we had, let me say this is my resistor. What? How much ohm? 27 ohm. Now, this resistor I am cutting into 3 equal parts. So, I am connecting this into, this is R1, this is my R2, this is my R3. When I am connecting this into 3 equal parts, it means that this 27 you should divide by 3. That is 3 ones are 3, 3 nines are 27. It means that each resistor is 9 ohm. Okay? Understood? Total hamara 27 ohm ka ek resistor tha, usko hum 3 parts mein cut kiye. So each kitna hoga? Each resistor will become 9 ohm. Because 27 you have to divide by 3. So, it becomes 9 ohm. Now, we know that when the resistors are connected in parallel, now we have to find the total resistance, means Rp. Now, I want the value of Rp. But formula is 1 by Rp equals 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by R3. That is equals to 1 by 9 plus 1 by 9 plus 1 by 9. As you can see, the denominators are same. Okay, we have to take the LCM. 9, 9, 9. LCM is 9. If denominators are same, we can add the numerators. We can add the numerators. 1 plus 1 is 2. 2 plus 1 is 3. 3 by 9. So, 3 ones are 3 threes are. Answer is 1 by 3. But remember, always you will get answer in the form of 1 by Rp. That is 1 by 3. But you have to take the reciprocal. You have to keep the answer in terms of Rp. So, 1 by Rp, if you take reciprocal, it becomes Rp by 1. Is equals to 1 by 3 will becomes 3 by 1, that is 3 ohm. So, the correct answer is option B. Now, here we have the next question. The chemical equation that represents neutralization reaction among the following is. Now, in the given equation, which follows the neutralization reaction? Which follows the neutralization reaction? Okay. Now, I will give one small example for neutralization reaction. What do you mean by neutralization reaction? Suppose, example, I have 10 rupees. How much? 10 rupees. I have 10 rupees with me, initially. After some time, I have 6 rupees with me. Understood? Now, if you want to make this 6 rupees as 10 rupees, what you should do? You should add? Why? To balance. To? This is what neutralization reaction. Understood? In case, if the solution is highly acidic, then what you should do to neutralize the reaction? You have to add basic. You have to add basis. Understood? Example, your gastric problem. When more acidity happens, what you should do? You will use ENO to neutralize the reaction. Antacid. We call it as antacid. Any doubts? So here, which is the neutralization reaction you have to identify in this? So which among the given reactions are neutralization reaction? Observe here. इफ यू वॉन्ट टू न्यूट्रलाइज द रिएक्शन फर्स्ट यू हैव टू आइडेंटिफाई ऑलवेज एसिड यू शुड एड विथ बेस when acid reacts with base or base reacts with acid then the reaction is called as neutralization reaction now you want to identify acid and base example let me take barium chloride H2SO4 both are acid can you combine both acids to form neutralization reaction no so option A is wrong You take magnesium oxide, hydrochloric acid. Again, here also we can see both are not acid and base. We want acid and base. When these both react with each other, then the reaction will become neutralized. Are you getting? Now you can see NaOH, sodium hydroxide OH, that is base. Sodium hydroxide is base. H2SO4 is acid. Now here we can say that this base reacting with acid, hence the reaction is formed is neutralization reaction. So option C is the right answer. Okay, remember my dear students, sodium hydroxide is the base. When it reacts with H2SO4 sulfuric acid, then it will gives you sodium sulfate and water. Okay. And one more thing very important you have to remember when acid reacts with base what is the product is formed the example you don't know assume you don't know what is barium chloride what is H2SO4 you don't know assume it we don't know BaCl2 is acid or base we don't know BaCl2 is acid or base remember this we don't know And also we don't know for some time MnO2 is also acid or base also we don't know. Then how can we predict whether it is the given reaction is neutralization reaction? We have the standard form, we have the general form of neutralization reaction. When acid reacts with base, it forms salt plus water. What is formed? Salt plus water. Now in this four outputs can you see this in the four outputs what is formed in which reaction can you see water is obtained yes this is the clue are you getting my point only salt plus water no other byproduct should be there only water and salt should be there no other byproduct should be there are you getting my point if you see that option C is the right answer because this is the salt and this is the water Is this clear? Good. Now let me solve the next question. By constructing Khadin check dams in level terrains, okay? They are constructing Khadin check dams in level terrains. What is the use? What is the purpose they are doing this? What is the purpose of constructing Khadin check dams? See here. Now, different places, peoples have adopted different techniques to store the water. Are you getting? Some of them, what they used to do, they will make reservoirs. जैसे कि घरों के सामने एक खड्डा खोद देते थे, जिसके अंदर पानी को क्या करते थे? जब भी पानी आता है, उसको store करके रखते थे. Understood? When summer season comes, they can use that water. Are you getting my point? They were adopting different techniques to store the water so here Khadin check dams has been constructed in the level terrains as you may have seen the like the valleys in such type of places yes very good which chapter this question belongs to sustainable management of Very good. So this is the way you have to identify. For that reason, I said you one thing. Whenever if you are studying your previous year papers, please just at least see the titles of deleted chapters. At least once you see the titles of the deleted chapters, along with that, just read the questions of the deleted chapters. So at least some common sense should be applied over there. So what happens if you see something? Yes, this belongs to deleted chapter. I am not asking you to behead the answers, because no, it is very crucial point. It's very critical thing for you people to eliminate the things what is not required. So my dear students, this topic is deleted. In case if it was the question, it's a general question, okay. By constructing Khadin check dams in level terrains, why they used to do this? They were doing this because to underground water level increases. Underground water level increases. If they are going to construct this type of dams, due to this what happens? Underground water level was increasing. For that purpose, they were constructing this type of dams. Now, let me see the next question, number 7. To obtain a diminished image of an object from a concave mirror. Now you want diminished image, you want very small image, okay. Position of the object should be, where should be the position? See here. Now we have 6 ray diagrams. We have 6 ray diagrams. Now here the condition is what? To obtain the diminished image, I want small image. I want small image. If you want small image in concave mirror, please, these are the key points you have to underline. I want diminished image, and which object, which mirror I am using? Concave mirror. Where should be the position of the object? If you see your ray diagram, we have kept beyond C. If you are going to keep beyond C, example, let me take, this is my principal axis. Assume this is my principal axis. Let me say this is my center of curvature and this is my concave mirror. This is my concave mirror. If you are keeping the object beyond C, means behind C, let me say AB is my object, then what happens? You have to draw one ray of light which is parallel to principal axis. Now between C and this is P, and mid of this is focus, correct? So what happens? The ray will reflect in this direction. Are you getting my point? When AB is the object, let me say it is standing vertically on the principal axis. When this ray of light, once if it reflects, ek bar concave mirror ko touch hone se kya hoga, reflect hoga. So it is reflecting in this direction. It is reflecting in this direction, it is passing through F. And also you can see one more ray of light will be passing through C, correct? And again it will bounce back in the same direction. Now, these both reflected rays are meeting at this point. They are meeting at this point. So, this is the image formation. Now, if you compare this length and if we compare this length, as you can see, this is high or big or enlarged and this is small or less or diminished. So, where the object should be kept? If you want diminished image, the object should be kept at beyond C. If we keep beyond C, then we get diminished image. In the previous class, in the ray diagrams, when I have done class with you all, I have told you people, they will ask you such type of questions from the ray diagrams. Is this clear? Just they will give you the nature. They will give you the nature of the position of the object. Just by seeing the nature of the position of the object, you should be in the state to tell what is the position of the image. If they ask you what is the position of the image, what is the position of the image? Between C and F. Very good. We have discussed in the previous class. Correct? The position of the image is between C and F. What is the nature of the image? Real line inverted. What is the size of the image? Diminished. This is the way you have to answer. Is this clear? Very good. Now, let me solve the next question. Number 8. The electronic configuration of element X is 2881. Okay. We have one element x, we don't know. I am not telling which is that element. Assume it is x. चाहे सोडियम है या हीलियम है या कार्बन है, फेरस है, लेट इट बी एनी एलिमेंट, बट जनरल इज x. इलेक्ट्रॉनिक कॉन्फ़िगरेशन इज 2881, एंड द इलेक्ट्रॉनिक कॉन्फ़िगरेशन ऑफ y इज 287. देन द टाइप ऑफ बॉन्ड फॉर्म्ड बिटवीन दिस टू एलिमेंट्स इज, विच टाइप ऑफ बॉन्ड इज फॉर्म्ड बिटवीन दिस टू एलिमेंट्स? Yes, see here, example, let me take, this is my element x, as you can see the orbit, in the first orbit we have 2 electrons, in second orbit we have 8 electrons, in the third orbit we have 8 electrons, in the fourth orbit we have 1 electron, remember? Similarly we have one more y, okay, element y. So what, how many electrons are there in the first orbit? 2. Second orbit 8. Third orbit 7. Now which one wants to become octet structure? Yes, who wants to become octet structure? Y. If a Y want to become octet structure, then how many electrons it is required? 8 electrons. It requires 8 electrons. So what he will do? He will take from X. If any element is taking the electron, then which type of bond is formed? Yes? Which type of bond? Are you sure? Covalent bond, hydrogen bond, metallic bond, ionic bond. Is it ionic bond? No. Very good. The correct answer is? Covalent bond. When ionic bond is formed? When ions forms. Example, you take any molten state solution, in that if you pass the current electricity, then you can see it forms hydrogen H plus and OH minus ions. If ions is formed, H plus ions forms, then it is called as ionic bond. Understood? Example, electrolytic refining of copper. Electrolytic refining of copper. I hope you remember. Yes or no? We have the diagram like this. Here chlorine gas. Do you remember? This is anode. This is cathode. Remember? Here we have one outlet. Here we have one outlet. Do you remember? When you pass the current, when you pass the electricity, are you getting my point? So what happens? Chlorine gas is produced at cathode. Hydrogen gas is produced along with some one more product is coming. NaOH. Sodium hydroxide. Are you getting my point? Yeah, here in this reaction, as you can see, which bond is formed? Ionic bond. Remember, if you pass the current, if any reaction is happening because due to the presence of electric current, then we call it as ionic bond. Understood? Good. Concepts are clear? Understood? If sharing of electrons are there, this is called as sharing with caring. Dekho beta kitna acha hai, sharing with caring. देखो इन्हें शेयर कर रहा साथ में केयर भी कर रहा. ओके, कम टू द पॉइंट. अंडरस्टूड? इफ शेयरिंग ऑफ इलेक्ट्रॉन्स आर देयर, कोवेलेंट बॉन्ड. ड्यू टू द प्रेजेंस ऑफ इलेक्ट्रिसिटी, इफ एनी आयंस फॉर्म्स, आयोनिक बॉन्ड. नेक्स्ट क्वेश्चन, वेरी इंटरेस्टिंग. पार्ट ऑफ द फ्लावर दैट डेवलप्स इनटू फ्रूट. Part of the flower that develops into fruit and part of the seed that develops into root respectively are among the given options. Please see the question carefully. We have one part in the flower. Dekho beta, ek flower mein ek part hai, okay, that develops into fruit. Ek part hai, samjho, this is the part. Understood? As it grows, it will converts into fruit. One part is there in the flower. Once if it develops, it converts into fruit. And one more part is there in the seed. This is the part of flower. Part of flower converting into fruit. Part of seed converting into root. Which is that? Which is that part? Remember, the part of the flower which is converting into fruit, that is known as ovary. Remember? Yes or no? If you have seen the germination of pollen grain, the germination of
pollen grain.
Do you remember the diagram? The germination of the pollen grain. It's something like this. Correct? Can you remember the diagram? Are you getting my point? This part we called as ovary. Is this clear? So this is the part which is called as ovary. So what it does, it will converts into fruit. Part of the flower which is converting into fruit is ovary. Now sir, ovary is here also, here also, here also. But now interesting fact is what? Which is the part of the seed which is developing into root? Part of the seed which is developing into root. Which is that part? Very good. That is? One more. Sir, radical is here also, here also. Radical is here also, here also. See, this is the way they will make you to get confused. Got it? So, the correct answer is option C. Ovary and radical. Which is the part of the flower converts into fruit? Ovary. In ovary, flower will converts, develops into fruit. Seed, it will converts into roots. That is radical. Any doubts? Good. Next question. See children, very interesting question. A pure dominant pea plant producing round yellow seeds is crossed with pure recessive pea plant producing wrinkled green seeds. The number of plants bearing round green seeds in the F1 generation of Mendel's experiment is? See here. We have pure dominant pea plant. This is important word. Pure. Pure dominant pea plant. Producing. What it is producing? Round yellow seeds. Got it? Understood? Pure dominant pea plant producing round yellow seeds. This is my input. This is my pure dominant pea plant. And what it is producing? Round yellow seeds. Now I am going to cross this. With pure recessive pea plant. Pure recessive pea plant producing wrinkled green seeds. Wrinkled green seeds. So the number of plants bearing round green seeds in F1 generation of Mendel's experiment is? Children, based on this topic, I will be discussing in detail about F1 progeny and F2 progeny, how Mendel has constructed this experiment to explain the dominancy, that is the principle of dominance. Are you getting my point? So, we have two theories related to this, laws of dominance. I will be discussing in one more video in detail about this. Understood? So, how it happens in monohybrid and how it happens in dihybrid. Are you getting my point? So, monohybrid plants, how F1 and F2 generation will take place. In dihybrid plants, how F1 and F2 generation will take place. So, according to this question, so what is the correct answer? Option A, 0. Option A, zero. Actually, it's a very big, lengthy concept to explain, but right now we don't have that much time. You can just go ahead with this answer. But related to this topic, I'll be going to give you a very brief explanation. Got it? Good. Next question. See here. The functions of hormones are given in column A. Functions of hormones, they are given in column A. And the names of the hormones are given in column B. Match them and write the answer along with its letters. First question. Prepares the body to deal with the situation. Which hormone? They have given the function. Now you have to identify which hormone does this function. Which is the hormone prepares the body to deal with the situation? Example, now you are in a good mood. Some hormone is there which is making you to prepare to face that situation. Understood? You are in sad mood. You are in angry mood. Are you getting my point? We used to perform different moods, right? Understood? So, which is the hormone which is helping for us to adjust according to that specific time? Yes? Which is the hormone which is preparing to deal with the situation? Example. Example. Hey, do you know? You have got the result, you have failed. Huh? Heart attack. But it doesn't happen. They will adjust. Fail only, no? How many subjects? Yes or no, man? See, if that hormone was not there, then directly he will die. So, which is the hormone which is helping you to adjust with the situation? The answer is adrenaline. Understood? That is called as adrenaline. And remember, adrenaline is also called as emergency hormone. Adrenaline is also called as emergency hormone. Next question. Regulates metabolism for body growth. Which is the hormone regulates the metabolism for body growth? Yes? Still, options are there. Don't worry. See, insulin is there, thyroxine is there, estrogen is there. Okay? Regulates the metabolism for body growth. Yes? Very good. The correct answer is thyroxine. Okay? Regulates the metabolism for body growth is thyroxine. Regulates blood sugar level. It is regulating, it is controlling your blood sugar level. Which is the hormone? Very good. That is insulin. Insulin is the hormone which is regulating your blood sugar level. Are you getting my point? Example, diabetes patient. If a person is facing a diabetes, then which injection is going to be given to them to control the blood sugar level? Insulin. Correct, no? Huh. Next question. Regulates the growth and development of the body. Yes? Very good. The correct answer is? Yes. That is growth hormone. Any doubts, children? As you can see, one question specifically they will ask you related to your biology diagrams functions. Understood? Maybe your brain parts. They may give you in A column parts and in B column they can give you the functions of them to match. Or you can take your heart diagram parts and they will ask you to match what is the function. Are you getting? So this is the way they can ask you the questions. You should be perfect with these all areas. Okay? Next. Answer the following questions. See you. Name the acid present in the stinging hair of nettle leaves. Yes? Methanoic acid. Very good. The acid which is present in the stinging hair of nettle leaves. Example, have you seen honeybee? Honeybee? Once if it bites, I think you can see how it what happens on the skin. Have you noticed that part? Are you getting my point? Yeah, this is the thing. So which is the acid is present in the ant sting or the stinging hair of the nettle leaves? Which is the acid? Methanoic acid. It's an important question. This question has repeated most number of times in exam. The acid which is present in the stinging hair of the nettle leaves is methanoic acid. What are fossils? What are fossils? Yes? Fossils? The preserved traces, if you want, you can make a note. The preserved traces of the living organisms. Are you getting my point? Have you seen dead body? Dead body skeletons? Yeah, those are the traces. Once upon a time, they were a living organism. But still we have those evidences. Still we have certain proofs. Those are we called as fossils. Okay? The preserved traces of living organisms. You may have seen Harappan civilization, Mohenjo-daro civilization, Egyptian civilization. Are you getting my point? You may have seen in the Discovery channels, right? We have invented this this period, some traces we have found. Have you noticed this type of words? Yes. Those we called as fossils. Those are the traces of the past living organisms. The preserved traces of living organisms are called as fossils. Next question. Convex mirror. We have already done with this part. Convex mirror is commonly used as rear view mirror in vehicles. Why? Why we use convex mirror in rear view rear view mirror? Very good. In rear view mirror, we want the first thing is we want the wider view, and more than that, important word is. More than that, one more important word is there. Why we use convex mirror in the rear view mirror? Why we use convex mirror as rear view mirror? Wider, ठीक है. अब हमना पूरा image तो दिखना ठीक है. Well and good. But still, more than that, one more important word is there. To get the diminished image, because we want, example, if any vehicle is coming behind your vehicle. You want that complete vehicle movement. You want to see the complete movement vehicle, right? You want to see the complete size of the image of the vehicle. Yes, that is the answer. So convex mirror is commonly used as a rear view mirror in vehicles. Why? Because to see, if you want, you can write like this. Because they always give an erect erect, because they always give erect and diminished image, and also they have a wider field of view as they are curved outwards. Okay, next question. What is roasting in metallurgy? Yes, is this topic is there or deleted? Dear students, this topic comes under your occurrence of metals, but this topic is deleted. Is this clear? Next question. Observe the given figure, name the eye defect. Even this topic is deleted, it comes under human eye and the colorful world. So your question number 15 is deleted, 16 is also as per the reduced syllabus. What is Tyndall effect? Even this topic is also deleted. Next question. Under what condition lactic acid is produced in the muscle cells? Yes? Lactic acid is produced in the absence of oxygen. Very good. Take down the answer for question number 18. Excuse me. In what condition lactic acid is produced in the muscle cells? In the absence of oxygen. Are you getting aerobic, anaerobic respiration? Do you remember? Good. In the absence of oxygen, lactic acid is produced in the muscle cells. So that you will find muscle cramps. See here. I hope you have seen example when a person is running for certain a period of time or if he is running for certain distance, you can see he will get a muscle cramps. अब देखो बेटा कोई अब अगर से दौड़ रहे इफ यू आर रनिंग यू मे हैव सीन इन योर मसल्स यू विल गेट द क्रैम्प्स यू विल गेट द पेन व्हाई इज दिस ड्यू टू एब्सेंस ऑफ ऑक्सीजन इफ प्रॉपर ऑक्सीजन डजंट मूव्स देन वी फाइंड मसल क्रैम्प्स इवन यू कैन सी इन दिस एज ऑल्सो इफ आई आस्क यू पीपल टू सिट फॉर सम लॉन्ग डिस्टेंस सॉरी लॉन्ग ड्यूरेशन ऑफ टाइम सर बॉडी इज पेनिंग सर लेग इज पेनिंग सर व्हाई इज दिस Because no proper oxygen is supplied to your muscles. If there was proper oxygen was supplied to your muscles, then there were no muscle cramps will produce. Understood? So what happens? Lactic acid will produce. This lactic acid will create pain in your muscles. Any doubts? And also you have breakdown of glucose in various pathways. Are you getting my point? Yeah. Even in that also we have discussed about this topic. Next question, number 19, draw the diagram of an electric circuit in which the resistors R1, R2 and R3 are connected in parallel, including an ammeter and voltmeter and mark the direction of current. When the resistors are connected in parallel, I hope you have done with this part. Good. You can draw the circuit diagram when the resistors are connected in parallel. Okay. Next question, name the brown fumes, Name the brown fumes liberated when lead nitrate is heated. Write the balanced chemical equation for this reaction. Name the brown fumes liberated when lead nitrate is heated. It comes under your chemical reaction and equation. What happens when lead nitrate is heated? See, we have the formula of lead nitrate. PbNO3. Twice, understood, PbNO3 twice, once if you heat this, when you heat this lead nitrate, what happens, it gives lead oxide plus nitrogen dioxide plus oxygen, understood, but here what was the first question, name the brown fumes, which among this, which is the brown fumes is nitrogen dioxide, this is carries the brown fumes. Understood? Which carries fumes? Fumes means gases. PbO is lead oxide. It is not a gas. Understood? So here, which is producing brown fumes? For first question, what is the answer? Which is producing brown fumes in this? Nitrogen dioxide. That is NO2. First, you have to write this answer. Okay? When you heat lead nitrate, which is producing brown fumes? Nitrogen dioxide produces brown fumes. They are asking you to write the balanced chemical reaction equation PbNO3 twice. It gives PbO plus NO2 plus O2. If you balance this reaction, I hope you remember how to balance the chemical reaction. See, if you don't know, I'll just show you how to balance it. Observe you carefully. See here. In this case, Pb, we have one Pb, one lead compound. NO3 twice means NO3 two times you have to take. NO3 two times. Are you getting my point? Yeah. Here how many? Now, among this, NO3 we have twice, two times. Now here, as you can see here, is it the equation is balanced? No. How can you balance this? How will you balance? इज वेरी गुड. व्हाट वी हैव टू पुट हियर? टू. इफ यू पुट टू पी बी एन ओ थ्री ट्वाइस देन व्हाट इट बिकम्स? टू पी बी ओ फोर एन ओ टू प्लस ओ टू. नो द रिएक्शन इज बैलेंस्ड. ओके, इफ यू डोंट नो हाउ टू बैलेंस द केमिकल रिएक्शन, ओके, यू कैन जस्ट पुट इन द कमेंट बॉक्स. आई विल जस्ट हेल्प यू आउट एंड आई विल मेक सेपरेट वीडियो ऑन बैलेंसिंग द केमिकल रिएक्शंस. ओके, आई विल शो यू द स्टेप्स, द इजिएस्ट मेथड, द शॉर्टकट मेथड, हाउ टू बैलेंस द केमिकल रिएक्शंस. बट अकॉर्डिंग टू दिस इक्वेशन, 2B NO3 twice, it gives you 2 PbO plus 4 NO2 plus O2. So this is the balanced chemical reaction. Copy down. Yeah, next question. Explain the process of translocation of food materials in plants. Explain the process of translocation of food materials in plants. Take down. Take down the answer. I'll explain you in the similar way. The transport of soluble products, the transport of soluble products of photosynthesis, the transport, what do you mean by transport? Movement. You are moving. What you are moving? Soluble products of photosynthesis. The transport of soluble products of photosynthesis is called translocation. Is called as translocation. You are shifting. Location. Trans means you are transiting or you are shifting the soluble substances. The transport of soluble products of photosynthesis is called translocation. Full stop. It occurs in the phloem. It occurs in the phloem. Phloem is the food conducting tissue. So where it is happening? Where this translocation is going to take place? In phloem. Full stop. Next point. The products of photosynthesis are transported. The products of photosynthesis are transported where the photosynthesis reaction is happening? In the leaves. In the leaves where? In the stomata. Do you remember? Yes. Here, the products of photosynthesis, imagine photosynthesis process has taken place. The products has formed. Photosynthesis process hone ke baad mein products ban chuke hain. Ab ye kahan se kahan jayenge? How they are moving? From where to where? Are you getting my point? Now take down. The products of photosynthesis are transported from leaves, L-E-A-V-E-S, leaves, to all parts of the plant body. Full stop. Did you understood this? Full stop. Next point. Translocation takes place in the sieve tubes. S-I-E-V-E. Translocation takes place in the sieve tubes with the help of companion cells. So this is how the process of translocation of food materials takes place in plants. Is it simple? Concepts are clear? How the translocation will take place? Or next one more question is there. Explain the process of digestion in the small intestine of man. How digestion will take place in small intestine? We have already done with this part. How digestion will take place in small intestine? Okay, take down the answer. First point, okay, we discuss here. Explain the process of digestion in the small intestine of man. How the digestion will take place? Take down the points. Point number one, digestion of food, you can just take the heading digestion of food in small intestine. Digestion of food in small intestine. See, it gives you still more clarity. Whenever you write any answer, अगर से आपको कोई question ऐसा पूछा है कि इसको briefly explain करो, you just give the title. Same question, you write the title, then you write the points. It looks good. Got it? Heading is what? Digestion of food in small intestine. Take down. Point number one. Small intestine is the site of site. Small intestine is the site of complete digestion. Small intestine is the site of complete digestion of proteins, comma, carbohydrates and fats. Correct? In small intestine only, no? All these products are going to get digested. Good. Full stop. Next point. Glands present in the wall of small intestine secrete intestinal juice. Now, in the walls of the small intestine, you can see there are glands are present. So, those glands, what they secrete? Intestinal juice. Full stop. Next point. Now, after glands, who is present in small intestine? Enzymes. We are giving the role of all the substances which is present in the small intestine. What they do, the specific function. Take down. Enzymes in the intestinal juice convert proteins into amino acids, complex carbohydrates into glucose and fats into fatty acids. Complex carbohydrates into glucose and fats into fatty acids and glycerol, glycerol, and glycerol. Full stop. So, this is the function of enzymes. Next point, digested food is absorbed by the villi present in the walls of intestine. So, this is how the digestion takes place in the small intestine of man. Is this clear? Good. Next question. Draw the diagram of a simple electric motor and label the following parts. You can draw this diagram. Next question. What are structural isomers? Name the first member of alkanes that shows structural isomerism. Take down the answer. What are structural isomers? What do you mean by structural isomer? take down the answer. What are structural isomers? One or more compounds that contain the same number of atoms, one or more compounds that contain the same number of atoms, but differ in their geometric arrangement, geometric arrangement, full stop. Same answer you can also define as or. You can take or for definition of structural isomer. A compound, one more definition you can take down. A compound which consists of same molecular formula but different structural formula, is called structural isomer. Full stop. Name the first member of alkane that shows the structural isomerism. That is butane. C4H10. Butane is the first alkane member which shows the structural isomerism property. Is this clear? Good. Next question. Draw the diagram showing the longitudinal section of a flower. I hope you can draw this. They are asking you to draw the typical flower, that is longitudinal section of a flower, and label the parts, style and anther. Next question. Draw the diagram of arrangement of apparatus used to show the reaction of zinc granules with dilute sulfuric acid and testing hydrogen gas. This test is also called as POP test. Remember?
Yes, sir.
Good. Label the following parts: soap solution, delivery tube. Next question. Is it advantageous to connect electric devices in parallel instead of connecting them in series? Why? Dekho beta. For example, I'll tell you. Imagine, this is my circuit, एक प्लग है बेटा, ठीक है? You just went and touched this circuit, touch किया. Assume you got a shock. What you have got?
Shock.
Okay. To help you, one more your fellow friend and came and touched you. What he will get? One more friend came to help him. What he got? See, if you connect them in series, what happens? If one circuit breaks, all the circuits breaks. If one device fail, all the devices fail. So this is the problem when we connect in series. अगर से आप सीरीज में कनेक्ट किए तो व्हेन यू कनेक्ट द डिफरेंट डिवाइसेस इन सीरीज इफ एनी वन कंपोनेंट फेल्स व्हाट हैपेंस ऑल कंपोनेंट्स फेल्स सो हाउ डू यू वांट टू कनेक्ट इन सीरीज अ पैरेलल नो सर इन पैरेलल व्हाट हैपेंस assume this is my one device. Okay, this is one device, this is my another device, this is my another device, three different devices. For this circuit is different, for this circuit is different, for this circuit is different. If this fail, we can repair only this. It doesn't affect this both because they are connected in parallel. Understood? Parallel is nothing but this is ground floor, you are staying, your brother is staying in first floor, in second floor your sister is staying. If anything damages happens in this floor, do you think that it will affect the rest of the floors? It doesn't affect. Understood? Then you can tell them, damage has happened in your house, then why you have to come and help you? Go and repair your work. If anything happens in my house, I will repair. Please don't be so jealous. Okay, you have to help. But in case of circuit, okay, we have to be like that. Anyhow, so the question here is what? Is it advantageous to connect the devices in parallel? Is it advantage to connect the devices in parallel? Is it advantageous? Is it good? If you are connecting the devices in parallel instead of series? Yes. Why? Why? What is the reason? Because it will not affect the other circuits. Take down our other components. Take down the answer. You have see, you have understood. But in science, remember, you have the subject knowledge, but you have to give the scientific reason. That is very important. Take down the answer for this. Take down the appliances. The appliances, appliances. The appliances means the things what we are using in our house. That is called as appliances. The appliances connected in series need currents of widely different values to operate properly. Correct? See, example, you have one device, assume. This will work, assume. I have this device. Please listen to this concept very carefully. I have one device. This is my one device. Assume this is my one device. Assume this will operate in 2 watt of current. How much power is required? 2 watt. जब तक आप 2 वाट का पावर उसे सप्लाई नहीं करते, दैट विल नॉट वर्क. अज्यूम वी हैव वन मोर डिवाइस, दिस विल वर्क विथ 4 वाट ऑफ करंट. वी हैव वन मोर डिवाइस, अज्यूम दिस विल वर्क विथ 8 वाट ऑफ करंट. नो यू आर कनेक्टेड इन सीरीज. अंडरस्टूड? इफ यू आर कनेक्टेड इन सीरीज, वेयर यू हैव टू सप्लाई द करंट? एट दिस एंड ओनली. यू हैव टू पास द करंट वेयर? एट दिस एंड. इफ यू पास द करंट फ्रॉम हियर, if you pass the current from here, how much current you have to pass? 2 watt. How much is required? 2 watt, no? So you will supply 2 watt. If you supply 2 watt of current, only this will glow. Do you think that this will glow? No. It needs 4 watt. Suppose I supply 4 watt here, then what happens to this? Blast. Because you are giving high voltage than required. Understood? So this is one more major problem if you connect in series. देखो बेटा, एक एक component का अलग अलग function है, अलग अलग power में, अलग अलग voltage में, अलग अलग devices work करे. If you connect in series, to control the speed or to control the flow of current is very difficult. Same way if you connect in parallel, how much is required? 2 watt. You give only 2 watt for this. How much is required for this? 4 watt. You give 4 watt only for this. Individually, how much you want, you can give that amount of current to operate it. Understood? But in series, it is difficult because we cannot operate. Understood? We cannot operate properly. But in case of parallel, it is easy to operate properly. Are you getting my point? Good. So this is what the appliances connected in series need currents of widely different values to operate properly. We want different currents to operate. Got it? Next point. I am giving plenty of points, but in exam you can write any 2 points. Okay. In a series circuit, comma, if one component fails, comma, the circuit is broken and none of the components work. Full stop. But in a parallel circuit, current divides through the electrical gadgets. Easily we can divide the current. How much ever you want, you can give that amount of current to work the particular device. Any doubts? Very good. Or, you can see one more question is there here. Or, what is this? According to Joule's law of heating, mention the factors on which heat produced in a resistor depends. According to this law, write the formula used to calculate the heat produced. This is the direct question from your textbook. According to the Joule's law of heating, which are the factors are, mention the factors on which heat produced in a resistor depends. Take down the answer if you want. Heat produced in a resistor depends on what? On heat produced in a resistor depends on what? So heat produced in a resistor depends on current. In bracket, if you want, you can write I, comma, resistance R, in bracket capital R, and temperature T. So we have the formula, that is H equals I square RT. This is the formula, correct? So, as you can see here, directly H is heat produced, it depends upon current, resistance and temperature. Now, one more question is there in this. What is that question? According to this law, write the formula to calculate heat produced. Yes, we have already done with this. Okay. Is this clear? Now, take down one more point. Heat produced in a resistor. But actually I gave you specific reason, that is temperature. But in exam if they ask you on what factors it depends, means you have to write this answer. Heat produced in a resistor is, you have to write this answer, okay. Heat produced in a resistor is option 1, directly proportional to the square of current, for a given resistance, full stop. Option 2, directly proportional to the resistance for a given current. Option 3, directly proportional to the time for which the current flows through the resistor. Through the resistor. Is this clear? See, in first option I have given about I information. In second option I have given about R. In third option I have given about T. So this is the main answer you are supposed to write. On what it depends means, you have to tell that it is directly proportional to the square of the current, I square, square of the current. And next option is directly proportional to the resistance, that is R. And next it is directly proportional to time. Is this clear? Next question, list the advantages of using fossil fuels or list the advantages of reduce and reuse to save environment. So this topic is related, it comes under sustainable management of natural resources. Now let me focus on the next question, question number 28. The focal length of a concave lens is 30 cm. At what distance should the object be placed from the lens so that it forms an image at 20 cm from the lens? Okay, see children, this is the numerical from the chapter light. From the chapter light, let me solve this problem. See here, in this problem they have given the focal length. So what is the focal length of a concave lens? Is 30 cm. Focal length is 30 cm. Okay, let me write here F is equals to 30 cm focal length. Do you remember? F, small letter F is the focal length, capital F is principal focus. Focus. Okay, focal length of a concave lens is 30 cm. At what distance should the object be placed? They are asking you to find the distance of the object. Remember, we have two types of distances, one is object distance. Other one is image distance. Object distance is represented by the symbol U. Object distance is denoted by U. Are you getting my point? And image distance is V. We have two distances. U is the object, V is the image. So they have given the focal length of concave lens. This is important. You have to remember, concave or convex, it is respect to concave lens. The focal length of concave lens is 30 cm. At what distance should the object be placed from the lens so that it forms an image at 20 cm from the lens? In what distance it is forming? 20 cm from the lens. So this is the values he has given. But remember, we have the formula that 1 by V minus 1 by U is equals to 1 by F. So you have to remember this formula. Okay, so what is the formula? 1 by V minus 1 by U is equals to 1 by F. In this, what we want to calculate? U. We want U value. So minus 1 by U, shall we shift to the other side? It becomes plus. So what it becomes now? 1 by V minus 1 by F is equals to 1 by U. Therefore, we can write that 1 by U is equals to 1 by V. What is V value? 20 cm. V is 20 cm. Please remember, one small alteration you have to do here. What is that is, he has given that at what distance should the object be placed from the lens so that it forms an image. It is forming the image at 20 cm from the lens. If they say that, if the image is forming from the lens, lens say, agar se image form ho raha, if the image is forming from the lens, then you should take it as negative. If the image is forming from where? From the lens. If they give you this word, from the lens, then you have to take this as negative. Later, I will explain you, related to this chapter, when we discuss still more n number of problems, I will explain you how the magnification you have to use, how these changes we have to do. Okay. But now, with respect to this problem, I am just telling you that, when the image is formed from the lens, then we have to take it as negative. That is 1 by minus 20. Is this clear? Then minus 1 by F. What is F? 1 minute. Okay. So before I could take this point, I'll just tell you few steps, please copy down. First, before you start this solving this problem, take down one heading. I'll tell you. A concave lens always forms a concave lens always forms a virtual erect image on the same side of the object. Okay, it is forming on the same side of the object. Now here we have taken that, what is the image distance? -20. Actually it has given 20, but we have to take it as -20. Similarly, what is focal length? They have given 30 centimeter. Are you getting? What he has given? What is this? 30 centimeter. But here also you should take it as negative. Here also you have to change that as negative. Minus. Got it? Understood? Because the image is erect and virtual. For that reason, now we can write that as 1 by u is equals to 1 by v, that is 1 by -20 minus 1 by -30. 1 by -30. Later in detail I will explain you how we have changed this minus from plus to minus or minus to plus. I will explain you. Okay. But for this problem you have to take down this step. Now see, 1 by -20 can also be written as minus 1 by 20. Minus, whether you write minus in the numerator or denominator, it is both are one and the same. Now this minus into minus, shall we write it as plus 1 by 30? Again, this minus 1 by minus 30 can also be written as minus of minus 1 by 30. You write minus in top or you bottom, or you write minus in the numerator, both are same. Understood? So it becomes plus 1 by 30. It becomes plus 1 by 30. Now, if you are going to take the LCM for 20 and 30, can you take the LCM? Can you tell me what's the final step? That is 60. LCM is 60. Then what happens? If you cross multiply, it becomes minus 3 plus 2. Minus 3 plus 2. That is minus 1 by 60. This is 1 by u. Yes? For 20 and 30, what is the LCM? 60. LCM is 60. Now this entire term multiply by 60. Minus 1 by 20 into 60. 0, 0, 2, 1s are 2, 3s are. Minus into plus minus. 1, 3s are 3. That is minus 3. Again, this entire term, 1 by 30, multiply by 60 LCM. 30 ones are 32s are. That is plus 2. Got it? So, minus 1 by 60. But we want u. Take reciprocal. 1 by u can be written as u by 1. Minus 1 by 60 can also be written as minus 60 centimeters. That's it. So, this is the numerical. Okay? Copy down. Yes, children. Now, let me proceed for the next question. See here. Growth of thread-like structures along with the gradual spoilage of tomato can be observed when a cut tomato is kept aside for 4 days. Interpret the causes for this change. Okay, very simple question. See, please understand the given problem. Growth of thread-like structures along with the gradual spoilage of tomato. You have one tomato. Chalo beta, ab hamare ghar mein tomato hai, theek hai? We have a tomato. You may have seen, if you keep the tomato for 4 days, you can see some decaying going to take place, or some thread-like structures will come out from the tomato. Yes or no? Spillage. That is called as spillage. ठीक है, इसका मतलब कि टोमेटो खराब हो रहा है. It is destroying. Yeah. Growth of thread-like structures in this tomato. You can see growth of thread-like structures with a gradual spoilage. Gradual means what? Slowly, slow, step by step. Slowly, 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 the tomato is getting spoiled. Tomato can be observed when a cut tomato is kept aside for 4 days. Means you have cutted this tomato. After cutting the tomato, you have kept the tomato as it is. Now this is the inside layer of the tomato. I have cutted this tomato into 2 parts. Okay. After I am cutting the tomato into some number of parts, I have kept that as it is for 4 days. After that, what we can see here? We can see that some thread-like structures are coming from inside tomato. Understood? Why is this change is going to happen? समझ में आ बेटा? Understood? जब टमाटो को 4 दिन तुम्हें कट करके ऐसा रखो छोड़ने के बाद में अपने को क्या दिख रहा, आपको क्या दिख रहा है उसमें? एक छोटे थ्रेड लाइक स्ट्रक्चर्स उसमें बाहर आए जैसा दिखाई दे रहा. क्यों? व्हाई इज दिस हैपनिंग? यस, व्हाई इज दिस? या व्हाई इज दिस हैपन्स? Actually, do not worry, this topic has got deleted. It comes under your spore formation, fragmentation, fission, vegetative propagation, spore formation. So, this is a topic related to spore formation. Understood? So, how do organisms reproduce? In that, your first section of the chapter is deleted. Formation of unicellular organisms. In unicellular organisms, how the formation is going to take place? How the reproduction is going to take place? So, this is related to, see, thread-like structures are coming, means those are called as spores. That is spore formation. So, this topic they have chosen from spore formation. But this topic is deleted. Now, we no need to study in detail about this topic for this instant of time. Okay, now let me see the next question. An electric refrigerator rated 400 watt is used for 8 hours a day. See here, one electric refrigerator we have. So, how much they have written the watt over there? 400 watt. Ab main ek fridge lekar aaya hu beta, uske upar kitna likha hai watt? Kitna power consume kar raha hai wo? It is consuming 400 watt. It is rated as 400 watt. Is used for 8 hours a day. You are using that for how many hours? 8 hours per day. An electric iron box rated 750 watt is used for 2 hours a day. 400 watt refrigerator we are using for 8 hours a day. Electric iron box rated 750 watt I am using 2 hours a day. Calculate the total cost of using these appliances for 30 days in the cost of 1 kilowatt hour is rupees 3. This is very interesting question. See, once upon a time, if you become a family man, then you have to keep the record of your expenses. Correct? Yes or no? After your marriage? No man, not after marriage. Now only. Okay. Got it? Because you have to keep the record, no? See, where I can save my money? Because as you can see here, 400 watt, we are using for 8 hours a day. Electric iron 750 watts I am using 2 hours a day. Then how much total cost? How much total cost is going to occur when these appliances, when you are using for 30 days? If the cost of 1 kilowatt hour, for 1 kilowatt hour 3 rupees, understood? Then how much cost you have to pay if you are using this for 30 days? Is it interesting question? Let me solve this. Observe here, the steps has to be followed. The total energy the total energy consumed by the refrigerator in 30 days. First, you calculate for 30 days. The total energy consumed by the refrigerator in 30 days, how much? 400 into 8. Correct, no? 400 watt. You are using for 8 hours a day. For how many days? 30 days into 30. 400 into 8 into 30. If you do this, then you get the value 9600 watt hours. Sorry, 96,000. If you multiply these two zeros plus one, three zeros. 96,000 watt hours. But you can see in the last he has given 1 kilowatt hour equals 3 rupees. He has converted into kilo. So, we can write this as 3 zeros means 1000. We can write this as 96 kilowatt hour. How much energy is consumed? Only refrigerator in 30 days, it is consuming 96 kilowatt hours of energy. Got it? Next, the total energy consumed by the iron box in 30 days, how much? 750 watt. How many hours you are using? 2 hours per day. For how many days? For 30 days. If you multiply 45,000 watt hours in kilowatt hours, 45 kilowatt hours. Concepts are clear? Understood? Now we got to know total energy consumed from refrigerator and total energy consumed from the iron box. Therefore, the total energy consumed by the refrigerator and iron box is equals to 96 plus 45, that is 141 kilowatt hours. Correct? From both the appliances, we are consuming 141 kilowatt hours. Now, therefore, the sum of bill amount, now how much ultimately we get the bill? The sum of bill amount for 141 kilowatt hours at the rate of rupees 3 per 1 kilowatt hour is equals 1 kilowatt hour is equals to 141 into 3. Understood? Total 141 kilowatt hours multiplied by 3. That is rupees 423. This is the final answer. Problem is simple. Understood? This problem is from the chapter electricity. Now let me solve the next problem. Next question. There is no change in the color of red litmus and blue litmus paper when introduced in an aqueous solution of sodium chloride. So I have, as you can see, we have red litmus, we have blue litmus paper. Two litmus papers are there. When I am adding them in the aqueous solution of sodium chloride, there is no change. It doesn't change any color. Red litmus, it is red only. Blue litmus, it is blue only. No color change is going to take place. After passing direct current, now what I did? Forcefully, externally, I am passing the direct current through the same solution. Then red litmus solution is converting into blue color. After you pass the current, red litmus is changing into blue color. Which product is responsible for this change? Which product is responsible for this change? Mention any two users of this product. First, you should identify which is that product. who is making this change to convert red litmus to blue, red litmus to blue, and also you have to name the product and also you have to write their uses. Okay, take down. Very simple, very interesting. Remember one important point. In case अगर से वो रेड में है या रेड में चेंज हो रहा, whether it is in red in color or it is changing into red, that is called as acidic in nature. That is acid. Understood? In case if anything is changing into blue color or it is already in blue, then that is base. Now red is changing into what? Now this red is changing into red litmus is changing into blue color. If red is changing into blue means it is base. Understood? It is changing into base. Now which is the base? Which is the base? Tell anyone name, man. Which is the strong base? Sodium hydroxide, NaOH. Why am I taking sodium NaOH? Because sodium chloride I am taking. Understood? Which is the solution I have taken? Sodium chloride. In sodium chloride, once if you pass the current, then what it does? It is converting red litmus into blue color. So answer, take down. Take down the answer. Sodium hydroxide, SODIUM, sodium hydroxide. Because of sodium hydroxide, red litmus is changing into blue color. In short, we can write as NaOH. NaOH. Now take down uses. Uses of sodium hydroxide already you have in your text, but still take down option 1. Uses, option 1. Degreasing metals. Degreasing metals. DEGREASING. Degreasing metals. Next option. Soaps and detergents. Next, paper making. Next, artificial fibers. FIBRES. Artificial fibers. Okay. Next question. As you can see here, a food chain in a polluted aquatic ecosystem is given. See here. Food chain in a polluted aquatic ecosystem. Ecosystem has got polluted. Observe it and answer the following question. Now, how is our ecosystem? It is polluted. Now, as you can see, fresh water change into algae and then fishes and then birds. Now, here the question is, which organisms are distributed more due to biomagnification? Why? Which organisms are distributed more? See, in this ecosystem, it is getting polluted, right? This ecosystem has got polluted. So, which organism are disturbed? Which organisms are disturbed more? इसमें कौन सा organism बहुत disturb करे ecosystem को जिसकी वजह से वो pollute हुआ? Which organisms are disturbed more due to biomagnification? Why? Yes? Take down the answer. Very good. For option 1, answer birds. Birds are disturbed more due to biomagnification. Birds are disturbed more due to biomagnification. Full stop. They are asking you the reason also. Why birds? You have to give the reason. Take down next line. As the birds occupy the topmost level in the given food chain, the maximum concentration of harmful chemicals causing biomagnification causing biomagnification get accumulated ACCUMULATED get accumulated in their body. As you can see in this, in the topmost level in the food chain, who is staying? Birds. So the maximum concentration of harmful chemicals where we have in the birds only. So this causes biomagnification. Is this clear? Good. Next option, this ecosystem will be destroyed gradually due to biomagnification. Is this ecosystem will be destroyed gradually or suddenly? How they are asking you the reason? This ecosystem will be destroyed gradually. This ecosystem will be destroyed gradually, slowly, slowly, slowly. It will destroy because of biomagnification. Take down the answer. Option 2. Biomagnification is the process of accumulation of non-degradable chemicals in the various tropic levels of food chains. Full stop. Next line. As the chemicals are non-degradable or cannot be washed, they cannot be removed from the organisms of the food chain. Full stop. This leads to gradual destroying of the ecosystem. Next question, you have to solve this. A student places a piece of cucumber, a glass piece, a banana peel and a plastic pen in a pit and closes it. Understood? What changes can be observed in these materials after a month? Give scientific reason for these changes. Is this clear? Student has placed cucumber, glass piece, banana, plastic, pen in a pit and closes it for a month. So what changes do you observe after a month? Okay, you can check. Next question. What is dispersion of light? Mention the color that bends the least and the color that bends the most when light undergoes dispersion through a prism. But do not worry, my dear students. This topic has got deleted. Okay? Spectrum, dispersion, rainbow, scattering, Tyndall effect. All these topics come under human eye and the colorful world. So, this topic has deleted. Don't get confused as soon you see the word dispersion of light. Sir, light came? No, sir. Light word is there, but that is not light. Is this clear? So, better be light. Okay. So, definitely atmospheric refraction, even this topic is also related to human eye. So, this question has deleted. Next question, number 35. Draw the ray diagram for the image formation in a convex lens when an object is placed at focus F1 beyond 2F1. So, two ray diagrams you have to draw. Next, write the differences between saturated and unsaturated hydrocarbons. You have this answer. Write the molecular formula, structural formula of alkene having 5 carbon atoms. 5 carbon atoms. Alkene. Remember, C5. N value is 5. General formula of alkene is CnH2n. So, C5H10. So draw the structure. What is C5H10? We call it as pentene. Simple. Next, carbon atom does not form C4 minus ion and C4 plus cation. Why? But do not worry, my dear students. Option 2 is deleted. Ethanol and ethanoic acid. This topic is deleted for you. Option 2 is not there. Next, draw the diagram showing the sectional view of human heart. Label the following parts. Aorta, chamber of the heart that receives deoxygenated blood. Is this clear? Next question, number 38. Name the major constituent of biogas. Name the major constituent of biogas. Write the properties of biogas which make it a good fuel. Name the two devices that work using heat energy of the sun. Or advantages of solar cells, two hazards of nuclear power generation. 39. Observe the table and answer the following questions. Elements A, B, C, D, E. Atomic number 11, 4, 2, 7, 19. Identify the two elements that belong to the same period. In which are the two elements belong to the same period and two elements that belong to the same group. Give reason for your conclusion. It is from your periodic classification of elements. Next question number 40. How does overload and short circuit occur in an electric circuit? Explain what is the function of fuse during this situation. It's there in your classwork. Mention two properties of magnetic field lines. It is there in your classwork. And you have to give reasons for these specific questions, as you can see here. Okay. Or again, as you can see here, again we have here also give reason questions. Next question number 42. Write the differences between homologous organs and analogous organs. Differences between sex chromosomes of man and sex chromosomes of woman. Sex of a child is determined by the father. How? Is this clear? Good. I hope, my dear students, you all have understood the topics, what all we have discussed till now, as these topics are very important for examination point of view. Okay? As the admissions are opened in our institute for the next year batch, if any students are interested, you are juniors, so you can recommend our institute. The admissions are open, and also we have already started with the crash course. If any students are interested, within this week they can join to the crash course. In the below description and also on the screen you can see the contact number, you can contact to us. Okay, and after watching this complete video, I hope you all are satisfied and you have got to know that how will be the questions will be asked in your board exam. So it is kind of a self experience for you people, so you can use this as your base, as like the basic platform for your next preparation. Got it? Share this video as much as possible with your all friends. Still, if you are not subscribed to my YouTube channel, Shasar Classes, kindly do subscribe it and click the bell icon. If you like this class, click the like button. Thank you. Take care. Keep watching. We'll come up with the next topic questions and even the next subject questions in the similar way. Take care. Bye-bye.